you want to get us started, Lloyd? I got a few things.
Okay, yeah. This is I'm Lloyd Allender. We got John Lee and Laura Lee here from board members from the St. Louis Real Estate Investors Association. This is our every Friday networking and haves and wants session. I do want to bring up a couple, you know, other than our main events, which are on the third Tuesday. Before then, though, we've got a lunch, our networking lunch, which is the first Monday, and if it's not on your calendar already, get it on there. August the 5th is the first Monday in August. So it's at the Applebee's on Olive and 270. At the actual address is 11950 Olive Boulevard in Creve Coeur. So easy to find, centrally located for coming from the north or the south or the west or from the city. And kind of central located in the county. So hoping to see everybody there, as many people can get away from lunch. I know a few might still have a job and you're limited on getting away. But we've had people sneak away from lunch, take a long lunch. I know. I invited one of my after I retired from Boeing, I was going to them all the time. I invited somebody from Boeing that was interested, expressed an interest, and I said, hey, come join us for lunch. So we took a long lunch. But anyway, you got that coming up, and we're here every Friday. And then John's got I'm going to let John talk about a Zoom session he's got set up for us exclusively for our group on August the 6th. You want to say a little bit about that, John?
Yeah, there we go. Okay. On August the 6th, the state of Missouri actually is putting on a special presentation for us. It's going to be on Zoom. This in particular is for women, minorities, and veteran business owners. And it's a certification. Some of you may know about it. Some of you may not. You need to be 51% owned. And once you get certified, she's going to tell us, it's Kimberly Hicks. We met her, I don't know, a couple months ago at the Small Business Expo. And she works for the state. It's taking us a while to get her to come back around, but we're happy to have her. And she put together a presentation for us to show you how to get certified. Once you're certified, then you can actually bid on government contracts. And there's a lot more to it than I have really time to talk about right now, but you do want to mark your calendar. I'll put a link in the chat. Let me find it here. But you do want to make sure if at all you're interested, we'll do our best to record that. I'm not sure how the state deals with that. I don't think they'll have a problem with it, but you never know. So I would encourage you to show up live for that. So that's coming up on August the 6th, which is a Tuesday, right after the lunch on a Monday. So we're going to have a busy week that week. Just a couple other things that I'd like to mention while we're, before we get started here too, will be our main event. Lloyd kind of touched on that. That's on, August the 20th, we're going to have, the tax sales are coming up on the fourth Monday of August, which is the 25th this year in the state of Missouri. They're all on the same day in every county. And we're going to have Dale Sweet. He's an attorney here. He does quiet titles, and he's one of the experts in our area. We're really happy to have him. Some of us just seen him in Gladstone a couple weeks ago. He was one of the speakers there. And we're real happy to have him. He does quiet titles. He had quite an interesting presentation, too, because he told us about the process. And I have personally been involved with a lot of quiet titles on tax sale properties in Missouri. And you can never learn too much. There's always something new that comes up, and Dale is really the expert in our area on that. So you want to be sure to mark your calendars for that for August 20th. He will be at our main event there. And right before the Monday, which is the sale, I'm also going to do I'm going to do a little mini master class. So if anybody's interested in checking that out, I'm going to do one on the OTC properties over the counter. I'm not sure if I'm going to do that on the 15th or the 22nd, but right around there too, because that all corresponds with it. So if you're interested in the thing I'm going to do, just let me know that too. I'll put my email in the chat again too, which is AMS 826 at yahoo.com. Also, if you don't, if anything you want to do, you can always get a hold of me there. I know last week we mentioned, and a couple of you did that, the landlord's best and worst experiences. I see Joey up there and a couple of the other guys that sent me some stuff. I appreciate that. Yeah, we're working on a project and it's going to be something that will help all of us in the long run here. So, another thing I want to mention is September 17th, our main event, then our main meeting. We're going to have the people coming in from Cost Segregation from Utah. And there's a lot of stuff that we missed. They talked to our group a couple years ago. And there's a lot of stuff that we miss as investors, even though we know a lot of stuff and we keep up on it. And that's one reason we come in here, so we can learn more stuff and keep up on everything. But there's a lot to do with energy credits and tax deductions also with your investment properties. So you want to make sure that you tune in for that. They're coming in to do a special presentation. If you are a CPA or you know any CPAs, I'd encourage you to invite them, because you will get the CE credits for those also. So that's something that's kind of a big deal. It's not for some of us that aren't licensed CPAs, but it is, because you'll find out a lot that they go through. The other thing is here too. Okay, I know I talked about this a little bit last week too, but we talked about we're talking about tax sales coming up. Next year at the St. Louis Area Real Estate Building, we have secured that spot for Scott Walterbach, who just did the Missouri Tax Sale Seminar. And you want to make sure that you sign up for that. Some of you guys already got on the waiting list. If you did not, send me a note and just give me your name, contact information. And if you're an attorney, a government employee, or a investor / professional, which is what covers a lot of us here. But you want to make sure you get your spot reserved for that. We got a waiting list we're putting you on right now. That will be June 20th, 2025. So I know the spaces are limited. This is, I'll tell you, this is one of the best things I've been to probably all year. I love going and sitting in the room with a lot of smart people. And I was talking about this earlier. I love being the dumbest one in the room, because I've learned so much. And this is just, these people are just some of the top people in the state and in the whole area, because Missouri is an interesting state as far as tax sales go. I've been around them a long time, but there's always stuff that I don't know, and they're constantly changing too. I mean, from year to year, between the lawsuits and all the stuff that comes up, that we have to deal with. So Dale Sweet, though, will be there on the 20th, and, he'll have time for Q&A and other stuff. So I really encourage you, if you're at all interested in a little bit of specialized investment strategies, to show up for these events. I think that's all I got right now. So I guess we can get started with our regular networking. Is Laura, you over there? You want to do our... Yeah, she's not virtual this week, so
yeah,
we'll get her live here.
Live, Laura, today.
And you act like you don't know if I'm over here. Good morning and welcome, everyone. First, I'd like to do a bit of housekeeping. Feel free to unmute yourself when it's your turn to speak. Please be mindful of everyone else by muting yourself while others are speaking. You're welcome to put any contact information that you want to share into the chat. We meet here to share deals, look for deals and solutions we have in need with our real estate. We are not your financial advisors, attorney, or accountants. We do not endorse or recommend any specific solutions or contractors here. You're advised to do your own due diligence to your own satisfaction before you invest. The first Friday of each month is Ask the Attorney with Ms. Catherine Davis. Our meetings are typically recorded, so only share what you want others to know.
Okay, thank you, Laura. Okay, with that, I think networking, haves and wants. If you're not ready to unmute yourself right now, I'll go ahead and I want to ask, I see we got one of our supporting vendors, as usual, Soto Property Solutions. David and Stacy both are on here. Hey. I'll give you a minute to tell us about your services, since you support us. We always try to recommend our members to support our supporting vendors. And also, while you're on, I know you are also on that St. Louis Housing Solutions Coalition. I know they met yesterday. I don't know if you got any news, because we're part of that. I know John and Laura were there too. So anyway, yeah, if you got a little, anything you could tell us a little bit about that, you know, I know you could probably go on for a long time, everything that's going on with that, but what recent developments there?
Yes. All right. Hello, everyone. I'm Stacy Lowe. I am a licensed realtor in St. Louis, and then I work for Soto Property Solutions, Dave. We are a full service real estate brokerage, but we specialize in property management. So if you have any investment properties in St. Louis or in Southeast Missouri, we would love to help you manage them. We do everything for you from start to finish. You're pretty passive income. We handle it all for you. The only time you're going to hear from us is if there is a major issue. Otherwise, we just do it all. We have we hold the security deposits, we do the marketing, we find the tenants, we screen them, we have our own lease, we do move in and move out inspections with photos, we handle all the marketing, or I'm sorry, all the maintenance, and we also do all of the accounting for you as well. So we make having investment properties pretty easy for investment clients. So give me a call if you want to have us manage your properties or you have any real estate questions. I'll put my name and email and number in the chat as well. But Stacy Lowe, my office number is 636-305-3380. And I'm extension 311. And then my email is Stacy, S-T-A-C-Y, at Soto, SOTOPS.com. And then the housing coalition. Maybe John and Laura can tune in or say a little bit too. Yesterday we had some speakers talk about homelessness in the city, and it was very informative, but I don't really know if that tied in directly to the much of for what the housing coalition's doing. But it was great to hear from those speakers and like their what they're doing in the city and the data and everything that they've gathered from like Houston. They're trying to follow Houston's lead. Houston has got their homelessness down 60%. So they're trying to follow in those footsteps and put those same kind of practices in place here in St. Louis and hopefully really help the unhoused community.
Okay. Yeah, I heard about the speakers, so I figured may not relate too much to rental property owners, but it's mostly a government subsidy type thing, and that
And maybe putting some incentives in for some private landlords to give these people a chance.
Sure.
Also, they work with HUD, so you're guaranteed the rent, and then if you know something else happens, sure, give you extra money. So if it's more of incentive to help give these people chances. So
yeah, and that's part of it, is trying to. It's the reason we're involved as a landlord community, that we can help with that if there's some government incentives for it, right? You know, for the most part, you know, other than feeling charitable, is that's about all we can do. So okay, thank you for your input, and
yes, thank you.
Okay, who wants to kick it off today here? Or haves and wants, if you have a piece of real estate for sale, are you looking for something, looking for a rehab project? Somebody might have something here. I don't know if we got any wholesalers on today that looking for an assignment. It's a good time to have, speak up, and we've got a group of investors here that may be interested in. I know we've started some deals here in the past. And here, and I also had our networking lunches. I was so yeah. I know of a few there. I talked about one of the cases last week. So,
hey folks. I have my family has a project in Vandalia, Illinois. I don't know if you go far that far out to the east, but it's a multifamily project. We're trying not to lose money on it, but we're really interested in joint venturing with someone who is familiar with, housing for sober living or former incarcerated or, you know, insurance stays or something like that, if somebody has that kind of experience.
Okay, so you're looking for a partner, like a financial partner? Or...
So the value of this particular building, it was a 17-unit multifamily building with one of those units being a restaurant space. Our best thought for making good money on this property is to move it back towards its original layout, which means a lot of renovation, and make it more of like a dorm set up for like a sober living, you know, program, that kind of thing. It seems like it's a big deal in Central Illinois, in that part of Central Illinois. There's a lot of groups that's moving towards that. And we think that's the best benefit. But we don't have the right, knowledge on those programs or the grants and et cetera. Like, we've worked with some grant writers, we work with some different people, but I think that's the best move for this particular project. And okay. The renovation could be like $1 million. I mean, like $1.5 million, mm-hmm. something like that.
Oh yeah, 17 unit building if it needs a.
Yeah.
Needs a lot. Okay.
We think we can get 30 units in there.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Turn them into dorm like units, take 17 into 30. Yeah. Okay. If anybody's interested in looking into a project, and you said Vandalia, Illinois?
Vandalia, Illinois. I'm going to put my number in the chat here.
Okay, yeah, if you do that. And why don't you go ahead and give your number, tell us too. So it'll be on our recording. So if some
somebody's
watching our recording later.
Yeah, so my phone number is area code 630-334-3433.
Okay. Very good.
All right. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
You said that was Vandalia, Ryan. Is that correct?
Yeah, Vandalia, Illinois.
Okay, I'm gonna give your contact information to Laura Lennington, who's not on here right now, but she deals with a lot of multifamily in that range, and mm-hmm. she also deals in Illinois. So I'm gonna go ahead and send her your info. Okay, so if she reaches out to you, you'll just know who that is.
All right, sounds good. Appreciate it.
Sure.
Yeah, that's right. I have been to a tax sale in Vandalia a long time ago, but that's about all I know. I know where it is. Okay. Who wants to be next?
I'm trying to be next. Can you see Aaliyah Shawman up there?
We can see, yeah. Well, I can hear you.
Okay. So I am. I've been to several of the lunches, which are a lot of fun. I'm sure.
Yeah. My video. I remember clearly. Our lunches. Yeah. And I hope you can get done next. A week from Monday.
Yeah, that'll be. I'll be there. And I am slowly rehabbing my second house. I plan to rent for a number of years, and then hopefully accumulate around 10 houses that I'll rehab. I'm a nurse, so I'm doing this part-time, and I'm interested in hearing about anybody else's experiences so that I can learn from their experiences with rehabbing houses and how they have done it. I'm in St. Louis, and I'm rehabbing in South City.
Okay. Yeah, I thought you were in South City. Yeah. Okay. So, okay, so you just like to, talk to some other folks that are rehabbing?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I don't know. I missed the last lunch. Were you there? I know Dave, I saw the attendance list. Dave Randolph was there. He does a lot of rehabbing.
Okay. I was not there last lunch. I had a birthday to go to.
Okay, yeah.
Well, I'll be there next time.
I was still recovering from COVID, so.
Oh, glad you recovered.
Yeah, I'm all better now. Okay. You want to put your contact information in the chat, and we'll also, if you want to give your phone number, you can go ahead and say it for our recording.
You want me to say it?
Yes, please.
So my email address is I'll put in the, it's my first and last name. I'll put it in the chat, and my phone number is 314 277-6016.
Okay. Very good.
Thanks.
Okay. I see Mary's got her hand up. Go ahead, Mary.
Yes. Good morning, everyone. I'm Mary from Chicago. So I just came across this meetup a week ago. So now I'm trying to put it weekly so I could join all of you. Reason why I wanted to raise my hand and speak is because I am doing commercial. So I am going to be bringing deals to this meetup. On commercial deals, I know most of you are probably in Missouri, the state of Missouri, because I'm aware of that. But I also wanted to know if there's anybody here that would also be interested in doing commercial deals in Illinois, in the Chicagoland area. I am going to be working pretty passive aggressive to start bringing some of those commercial deals in Chicago. So that's why I wanted to know if anybody was interested, if anybody's doing commercial, is looking into commercial. I would love to be connected with you if possible, if I can give my name and my number. You know, I mentioned short sales last time, so I will also be looking into also start negotiating a couple of short sale commercial deals that I could also start bringing into the group. So commercial is really where my area is. So can I give my contact information?
Sure. Yeah, go ahead and give your contact.
Sure. Again, Mary Flores, and my phone number is 847-257-5541. And my email is negotiate, like the word negotiate, and then and, A-N-D, like David, and then fund, F like Frank, U-N-D like David, at Gmail. So anything with commercial, it would be greatly appreciated. And if anybody here is already doing commercial and wants to connect with me, I would love to be able to network and really go into that space and that area. So thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Mary. Okay. Who wants to be next? Let's go ahead and unmute.
A quick question for Shalia. Yeah, yeah. I'm just curious about what level of rehab that you're taking these houses to. If it's like cosmetic or really down to structure.
You talk about Aliyah?
Yes.
Yeah.
Sure. I've done one, which was mainly cosmetic. I had the electric redone in the first floor. And this next one is more expensive. So I'm putting in the electric right now, and then I'll redo the plumbing, at least redo half of it, switching where the kitchen is. I'm changing it from a one building that had two apartments in it to a building that will be one unit of three bedrooms. And then I'll do all the cosmetic stuff. And I'm doing a lot of it myself. I have learned how to put in flooring. I know how to do all of the hard, just low-skilled stuff. I'm going to do the drywall by myself. I'll do the tiling by myself, but I don't know how to do the electric. And I'm sure that I could learn, but I don't know how to do the plumbing. So right now I'm getting the electric in. And it's exciting, but it's also a little nerve-wracking. So.
And it's pretty time consuming if you're doing it all yourself too. I'd appreciate it. I rehabbed my first house all by myself. It took me many years.
It took me about a year to do the last one. So I'm hoping that this will take me less time.
But we'll see. It gets quicker as you get better at it. Yeah, like everything.
Okay.
And just one more follow-up question, if you don't mind. Are you doing it yourself due to like the cost of buying these houses right now, or is it just extra value add?
I think it's extra value added. I'm a nurse, so I make a nurse's wages, and that's the money that I'm using to put into the property. And I purchased the property outright at $30,000, so I don't have interest on a loan. And I'll have to probably get a loan at the end for the furnace because there's no furnace. Nobody's lived in the house for 30 years. So I'll have to purchase a furnace and air conditioning system, put in the duct work, some of it anyway. And I have enough money saved up to put in some of the electric, but I figure that'll be cheaper if I do the work. And also, I don't know a lot of handymen. I know one handyman who has lots of experience, but is partially retired. And so works when he wants, half days on days that he feels like it. So if I can do the vast majority of the time consuming things, it will get done faster, even though I'm working on it part-time around my nursing hours.
Yeah, it's nice to know those skills, knowing what it takes to, the amount of work it takes to do certain jobs. And, you know, on your first project, yeah, probably a good learning experience. And then as you move on, you'll find out things you don't like to do so much, and you'll start finding, seeking out contractors to do those things.
That's funny. At least
that's been my experience.
That makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
Joey, have you
question, Aaliyah?
Yeah.
And you may have said this, but are you looking at selling this or keeping these properties when you're done?
So I'll keep this property. I'm going to try the Burr method. And so I'll need to keep this. And the first property was in actually my father's name. So while I rehabbed it and the value of the property went up a great deal, we're renting it. And I probably will for 30 years. It's in a great neighborhood. And he has it in his name with like a 2% interest on the mortgage. So that's going to stay that way for a little while. This next one is in my name. So I'll keep it in my name and I'll rent it, take the value, and then purchase another property and continue on. Eventually I may sell it. Right now it's in a neighborhood that's changing. There's a lot of rehab going on every block in a 10 block radius around the house and the block that it's on. But it's currently next to a house that is in LRA and is claimed by an LRA person who says that they're doing rehab, but they haven't done any rehab for last year. So I don't want to sell it because I think the value would be so much more in like 3 years or 5 years. So I'll hang on to it. I eventually may sell it, but for the time being, I will rent it. And probably I will rent it to a family that is getting a HUD voucher. I wanted to have 3 bedrooms so that I could make sure to have it the most desirable. And I went to the HUD office to find out if there was a greater demand for a 3-bedroom place or 2 1-bedroom places. And before I left, no fewer than 3 women took my phone number and asked me when the house with 3 bedrooms would be ready. So it should be 3 bedrooms. And I'm also happy to know that I'll create something. I'll create a place for people to live and have a good life out of something that's not any use to anybody right now. So,
yeah,
very exciting.
Yeah, we offer a great service. So, providing housing.
Yeah. Okay, Leah,
thank you.
Hmm? Yeah,
yeah. My name is Ann, and as a nurse and a rehab, we can talk offline sometimes, but I can tell you lots of do's and don'ts.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Thanks.
Sure. My phone number is in the chat and you can get yours too. Debbie, very helpful. I think it'll be successful. I'm just so nervous about all things. So I would love the support. Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah, okay. There's several things you have to be careful with, especially when you're for filing tax and so things like that, because if you're doing both, I got burned by that because they said I could not be a full-time real estate investor and a nurse. So I had to pay out a large amount because it should have just been one. You know, if you're going to do it part-time, you have to make sure you're saying part-time. So we can discuss offline. So we'll talk later.
I would love that. Thank you very much.
Okay, yeah. Sure.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Anne's got a lot of experience. She's one of our longtime members, so sure she could. Sounds like you got a lot in common. She could share some tips with you.
Hi, Anne and Alia. This is Sajanya. I'm on the same path. Please share, Anne. Can you please share your contact information? And I would like to get in definitely touch with you. And Alia, I got your contact information. That's very inspiring what you do.
Okay. Well, you want to share your contact information, Soya? So if anybody else wants to...
Sure.
Can get in touch with you?
Oh, sure. You want my contact?
Yes, Anne. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Thank you.
I will. I'll just put it in the chat. Sure.
Good. There you go. Okay. Okay.
I have a follow-up question.
Okay, go ahead.
So I'm echoing what Joey asked. So when you're purchasing a property and you know that it requires rehab, but what if it has a structural damage? And what do you actually consider structural damage and not a good investment property?
Well, it depends on how extensive the structural damage is, and if the, you know, you have to figure that the repair cost into what the purchase price and allow plenty of contingencies for other things you might run into, because, you know, doing structural repairs or, you know, there's, you know, companies that specialize in it. And if you got a, you know, a crack in a foundation wall or a settling foundation, those are issues that, you know, if you have a building inspector out, he'll definitely point those out, those issues out to you. And then you need to have get at least one contractor take a look at it to specialize in that kind of work, to so you know what you're up against.
Got it. Thank you.
Yeah, that's a great point right there, Inspector. Like you're saying, Lloyd, we do have one in our group, Pete Klarman. He did a presentation, I think, about a year and a half ago. And personally, I think it's, you know, especially if you're not real familiar with some of that kind of stuff, it's worth spending the $500 or $600 or whatever it is they charge to come out. I did that a lot, even though I thought I knew some stuff when we first started buying investment properties. And it was well worth it, because you get like a, I don't know, there's different levels of inspections you can get, but they'll climb up on the roof and you can go follow them around if you want. And they'll show you, talk to you about the plumbing, electric, foundation is always important. But that's the way, they'll give you like a 15, 20 page report on the house. So you get a lot for your money. And even if you're experienced, after you've been around for a while, you know, we still miss things. So it's really, a lot of times, just a little bit of money you'll spend on the inspection will save you a lot of heartache and a lot, tens of thousands, if not more, you know, hundreds of thousands of dollars on something like that. So I think it's well worth it to do that. And actually, that could be part of your education too. If you have your taxes set up the right way, I know we talked just a little bit about that. That's all deductible too. Even if you don't end up buying the property, that's something that you could do. So I would definitely consider that, you know, when you're moving forward on some of those.
Yeah. Especially if you're starting out, having a home inspection, that's worth it in educational value. If you follow them around and, like I said, go up on the roof. And if I've got one of my, you know, larger investments, I still call a home inspector just to make sure I haven't missed anything. And it was a couple of years ago. Yeah. He found something that, that I hadn't noticed, because I didn't go up in the attic, and he goes up in the attic too, and so there'd been a fire in the house, and so there were some other issues that came up from that, and I ended up saying thank you, and that saved him way more than his fee would just to get me out of that deal, and in any other times than one as I purchased, he found at least something, if not a little termite damage that I was able to use to, you know, negotiate a little better price on the house. So it usually almost always pays for itself to have a home inspector, and then you got a lot more comfort that you're making a good decision when you go in to close on a house.
I'm just going to pipe in and say that in case you do buy a house that you have issues with. Like, my brother just bought a house on auction for $4,000. You know, there, I have found a contractor that is really good and quick, has a lot of young, strong, motivated guys. And
Whoops, you just muted yourself, Aaliyah.
It's Quickness Construction. I saw them doing tuck pointing, and they do other things. So there's a contact in case. I think I put that up there, right?
Okay, so you put a contractor in the comments here. I'm going to go.
I tried to. Quickness Construction. There it is.
Yeah, okay. Quickness Construction.
Yeah, that's in South City.
Tuck pointing and other construction work in South City. Their phone number is 314-532-3101. Quickness. There you go. Thank you for that, Leah. Yeah, people are always looking for contractors. That's one of the things we do, a lot of referrals, and that's why we say, you know, always check them out.
Yeah, and Ryan, here's a, I got a message back from Laura. She's going to get a hold of you today. She's actually in Italy right now, traveling. That's why she hasn't been on here the last couple of weeks. But she'll get a hold of you today, and she'll talk to you more next week. But she's pretty much the one that would, she can get you in the right direction. She's great with networking, and she knows a lot of people. So right in line with what you're talking about there, multifamily in particular. So Lennington's her name. So just when she reaches out to you, just know who she is.
Yeah, I appreciate it. She's already made contact with me.
Oh, well, see, that's quicker than I can even get my message to you. So there you go.
Way ahead of you.
She's in Italy, so she's on top of it.
Yeah. Yeah, she stays on top of things. You know, she helped a friend of mine sell a house over in Wood River, Illinois, last year, I think it was. So
very cool.
Okay. She has a lot of connections and knows people, so I'm sure she knows somebody with the right qualifications to help you out with your program.
Yeah, Laura, she's really great. She helped me with 2 sales this year.
There you go. So you got more than one endorsement.
Yeah.
So I have a question. So I'm looking at, as I said last week, I'm looking into investing kind of like possibly the Burr method, like Aaliyah said, but looking in like West County area, and I'm trying to find the best tool or person to talk to for rent prices. And I don't know if that would be access to the MLS or what you guys think would be the best option to figure that out. Would it be talking to a local realtor?
I don't know. Maybe Stacy can have where is more
experience. Yeah, you can hire us as your property manager.
Yeah. Well, I'm looking into the first property right now, so yeah, I wrote down your information when you were speaking, so it's definitely in my mind.
A pretty easy tool it's usually accurate. You need to pay attention to it, but Zillow has a Price My Rental. A realtor, I don't love Zillow, but as a property management company, it is pretty helpful. But just look at other places that Zillow has. They also have a Price My Rental, and then like Facebook Marketplace, you can get on there and see what other ones are listed for in the area.
That's a good idea. Yeah. I was on Zillow, and I just didn't know how accurate it was. I guess the more dense the area is, it's probably
It's usually pretty close in the ballpark range, but you just got to pay attention, because like sometimes Zillow doesn't know if like a basement's finished or not, and that's gonna up your rent big time. So just kind of look at other listings that they have on there and compare it and see, but it's usually pretty close.
Yeah. Okay. And just a quick follow-up question, do you see a lot of rentals out in like the West County area?
It's not, they're out there, it's just not as much as the city or like North County, right? But there's definitely some rentals out there. Usually it's a little more of a targeted market, since that most places out there are bigger and nicer, so you're getting more larger families that either can't buy because they know they're going to move soon, or you know, maybe recent people, families that are splitting up or getting divorced or something. They're out there, it's just not as much.
I gotcha. Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay. Who wants to be next? Usually the more we talk, more questions come up. So I prefer give folks a chance. I was going to say that I use Zillow for a comparison for mine, but I just look at what's in the area. If I put in an address for one of my rentals, all it's going to do is look back at what I advertised it for last time. So,
right. Yeah.
And I'm looking for, I'm going to re-rent it now. And I'm looking at how much can I push the, and I usually end up trying to go a little bit under Zillow, but, I want to say is a few months ago, we had one of our longtime members was on here. And I said that, and he said, well, I always make it at least about $100 over what Zillow says. So, and that way he gets a lot fewer applications that come in. So,
yeah, I was trying to find properties that had been rentals for a long time, 10 years, and see, the progression of what they listed it for. Cause like sometimes I know people list for unreasonable amounts and then it's for six months.
I've seen that too. Somebody's like in St. Charles. I see, wow, look at somebody wants $2,000 for a 2-bedroom here. And then I look, a couple months later, it's still there. It's still advertised.
Yeah. Price reduction.
Yeah. Well, eventually, yeah, I say they probably did, but I don't look that closely, but I say, okay, I was right on not following that as one of my guidelines for setting my rents.
We used to use Rent-O-Meter. I don't know if they're
still around. That was another one.
They were pretty good.
I've heard of that one.
We actually talked to our group once, but that was one I used to use when we rented properties. It's rentometer.com. And I don't know if you might want to check those out, but I'd say talking to Stacy and Dave is always a good idea because they kind of know everything about our area here. They're up on that. So you're definitely at the right place.
Yeah. Rent-O-Meter is a good tool, but you have to pay for it after.
Oh, you do? I always got my free.
I noticed they changed that. Yeah. That's why I used to look at them, but I quit. And you just reminded me why I quit using looking at them.
Okay. Bigger Pockets has one too that I was using. I just don't know.
I'm sure there's other ones. Yeah. I see a hand up. Soyana?
I mean, a little deviated from what we are currently discussing. So last week I tried to buy a property and I have seen that every house that I tried to purchase is offered over they're getting offers over what the market price is, what they're listed for actually. So out of 10, let's say there are about 6 properties were getting offers more than the asking price. And I thought this is a buyer's market, but in reality, it's not a buyer's market. That's actually my experience. What are your thoughts about it? And can we invest now or do we hold back? What's your opinion?
Well, I'll make a comment about it. Yeah, if you're just looking on the MLS for listed, especially single family houses, it's going to be hard to buy something if you're looking for a rental or if you're looking to flip it. But there used to be able to go on to MLS and find what they call handyman specials, but those all usually end up going to wholesalers. These days, there's so many people out looking on the wholesale market that people that want to get rid of a place and needs work. Most realtors, I would say, won't include Stacy in that, but most realtors would don't want to touch something unless it's immaculate, move-in ready, and it's in super good condition. But there are other sources getting connected with wholesalers that might have properties that need a little work. John deals with properties for distressed buyers that are maybe getting ready to lose their house next week in a tax sale. If you can get a hold of those tax sale lists and go through that, you've got about a month to before that sale comes up and do some research and send out a few letters and knock on a few doors, maybe find somebody that is more motivated to sell their house that's not retail ready. I mean, that's about it. Just a comment that I'll make as an investor. I've back in the old days, I've been around a while, and Yeah, I used to be able to occasionally find a handyman special or something, or just by, you know, scanning the MLS on a regular basis, say, whoa, something looks wrong on this one. What's with this one? And find one that's priced a little below the market and go in and negotiate it. But those are coming pretty hard, you know, few and far between right now. So
do we have wholesalers in our group?
We do. Apparently, we don't have any on this morning here. In the past, we have.
I'm sorry, did you say wholesalers?
Say, Princess, go ahead.
Yes. Actually, Kay, I want to ask a question. For Joey, too, I've used a process called Investor Base. I know it's costly after the first week or so, but you can kind of see like what this house has sold for previously. And then I'm thinking if you go back on Zillow and then check to see, you know, what type of updates they did to see if it kind of fits the bird that you're looking for and see if they are actually, you know, renting at the price that they're asking for as well. But yeah, I'm actually in North County right now. I'm started and I had a question about tax sales, but I am in wholesaling.
Okay. Well, you want to add Sayana to your wholesale list then?
Yeah, please do.
Go ahead and put your contact information on there and Princess can pick that up.
Awesome. Thank you. And my question actually was about more about the tax process. I did see that there was a video posted on YouTube. Do you feel like that kind of adequately covers everything in regards to like the taxing process? Because I didn't have a chance to watch it yet, but that was on my to-do list after the meeting today.
Are you talking about Missouri, right, Princess?
Yes.
Yeah, Missouri's a complicated state. I would highly recommend showing up at our main event on the the 20th of August.
Yeah,
Dale Sweet's going to be there. He's one of the top attorneys in St. Louis area on tax sales. I'm going to do a little like a mini master class too, also on that before the tax sale, which is in the fourth Monday of August every year. So that's something, it is coming up. If you're going to go to the tax sale and buy at the sale, you really probably need to know what you're doing, because it's a process of how to contact the previous owners. There's a one-year process before you, or a waiting period basically before you get the deed. I've done a lot of tax sales, but I do them over the counter, and that's what I know really well. I personally have chose never to go to a tax sale because of all the different things to go to it, but it's good to know that stuff. And I don't think you were here. I know we chatted a little bit last night on Facebook, but and thanks for coming in too, by the way. We do. I would recommend that. We do have probably the top experts in the state of Missouri. In fact, I will say they are the top experts in the state of Missouri coming to St. Louis next year on June the 20th, 2025. And that will be in SLAR, the St. Louis area realtor building. And, Scott Walterback puts that on. You can kind of look up some of that stuff in the meantime. But it's a big process. I would not recommend just going to the sale first time without being a little educated and buying something, because I know people that's done that. I know people in our group that recently has talked about that. In fact, we were talking about that yesterday when we were over at the coalition meeting, and people has done that and then they let them go. And the city of St. Louis is different than the county of St. Louis, which is also different than every other county in Missouri. So that's, you just need to know the process. There's a lot of things that you probably want to know before you do that, but it's a great way to do it. And I'll tell you a little tip that I've used for years. When I used to exhaust counties that would run out of the list, I couldn't wait for them the next year in certain areas I was looking for. Get a copy of the list from the county that you're interested in buying the properties, and then contact the people ahead of the sale. I've gotten a lot of deals from people directly with avoiding the sales completely. And that's a really good way to get off market properties. Some people don't know what they can do. And I've gotten a lot of free properties that way, where they just signed them over to me. Now, them are not the, they're not the cream of the crop properties. They're ones that need a lot of work, but it doesn't make any difference. You know, if you're looking for deals, that's just a good way to do it. And there's not a lot of people, I don't think, that do that. There are some, and they do take a little bit of work to hunt them down. But mark your calendar to show up on August the 20th. Dale Sweet, he's the one. Bring your questions. He's going to answer a lot of things, you know, that, that you'll want to know. But it, yeah, in Missouri, it's kind of a, it's a weird state because it's a lien state and a certificate state. It's a mixed state, depending on what year tax sale, you know, certificate you would buy or whatever. It, it gets into a little detail. So you really kind of want to know what you're doing.
So yeah. John, could you tell me, I think it's a deed area in Kansas City and St. Louis, but everywhere else is lien.
It depends. There's a first, second, and third year tax sale. So they all, it just depends on what you're doing. And then they, you know, those two areas, Kansas City in particular and St. Louis, they're different than the counties are. Okay. They have a different process. It's still what it is that, and just to explain a little bit without getting too deep, but you have a first, second, and third year tax sale. The first year that goes to the tax sale, it would be a lien if you bought that. That's 3 years of back taxes. If you don't pay your taxes for 3 years, you will go up to the first year tax sale. If somebody buys that at the sale, they will get a lien on your property. You do not own it. And all you would get if and when they redeem it is, I think it's 9% or 9.5% interest. Okay, the second year tax sale would be 4 years of back taxes. Again, that would be a lien if you bought that. Now, if you get to the third year tax sale, which is what a lot of people like to focus on, that's 5 years of back taxes, then you will get actually issued a certificate, but you do not necessarily own the property right away. You have a 1 year redemption period, and there's stuff you have to follow. You have to, this is where you'll want to get, you'll want to go to our meeting or at least find out what the process is, because Dale Sweet's an expert on that. Then once you get that, then you will have to get a quiet title, which is another whole process to clear the title. Because just because you have a collector's deed or a sheriff's deed doesn't necessarily mean you have a clear title. Okay. And a lot of these tax, if you go to YouTube, and I don't know which ones you're looking at, but I've been through a lot of these kind of trainings, but a lot of them will tell you that if you buy a property at a tax sale, everything else is wiped out. That is not true at all. Okay. They're going to tell you that. And a lot of places tell you that. It may be true in other states. It may be true in other places, but it's not true necessarily here in Missouri. So there are people that still could have a lien on the property. There's ways to secure that and do the quiet titles. That's another whole process in itself. I had an attorney that I used to use who retired. We did, I don't know, basically probably hundreds of quiet titles. I never did the process myself. I am just now looking at maybe doing that myself. I cannot practice law as an attorney for anybody else, but you can do your own process. And I am in the process right now of looking at that, but that's another whole thing. But I would recommend, if you want to know about it, to come to the meeting on the 20th. That's what I would highly recommend. And you can find out more at STLREIA.com, which we try to keep stuff up to date. And as Lloyd knows, we do our best to give stuff over there. But you can always come here every Friday to ask us questions. Yeah. So
we'll get the latest right here, even before it gets on our website. So
that's perfect. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Is that at the Mola Shriner Center? Is that the same?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. So I was looking at the site and looking for
the Fifi Road. Yeah, we meet on the lower level. So you drive around the whole building, come in the back door, and you're shooting right into the Oasis room is where we meet. The Shriners. Okay. Yeah, as far as getting that list, I believe the lists are out now. I haven't stopped by I used to subscribe to the Business Journal, which would have the listings for the tax sale, and because they have to publish them ahead, and they're coming out now. And usually, you can stop at the courthouse and pick up a list too, or they'll have one posted. And that's what I was suggesting to Sawana. If he was looking for a motivated seller, that would be a list of maybe possibly some motivated sellers on that list. And you know, they've already been notified. If they're on that list, they've been notified that their house is, they're going to be on the tax sale, and they could lose their house. There's something going on in their life. They're financially struggling, or maybe they just forgot. It's a property that they haven't touched or inherited, and and maybe you'll hit them at the right time, and you can strike up a deal with them. So,
how do I find their contact information?
Well, that's another story. That's a whole nother, none of the seminars. Well, there's an address, and like I said, if you really go to tax sales and you're expecting to buy, you should take that list and drive it. Organize it by addresses and drive by the properties you may be interested in to see if there's any possibilities. You know, take that from a voice of experience. I bought a vacant house one time, or I bought a tax certificate on I paid the back taxes on it. Basically, that's what, you know, the first 3 or 4 years, you're not buying a piece of real estate, you're paying somebody's back taxes. And generally, if it's a nice house, before it goes to the third year, they'll pay their taxes and pay you a nice interest rate. And there's some companies that do that, you know, just buy them for the interest to collect a good interest rate. I ran into that in the state of Illinois. There's a bunch of hedge fund managers from Chicago that come around and make around to all the states. You know, they've got millions of dollars to invest, and they invest it, and they can even learn. I think they used to be like 24% interest, but that may have changed since then. But anyway, it's a whole business you need to know. It's a whole other business. And like John says, there's a lot of seminars to go to be very proficient at it. So, okay. Yeah, it's coming up on 12 o'clock here. Anybody else got anything?
One thing I'd like to add real quick. We're talking about our meetings, and I know we are switching locations after the first of the year, but we're also raising, I don't know if I'm supposed to throw this out there, but I'm going to do it anyway. If you're not a member of the STLREIA, I would suggest you join before the end of the year, because the cost is going to go up a little bit. It's only $75 right now for two people at the same address, and it will be 97 after the first of the year. It's not a huge savings, but it's well worth your while. And you get access to the member site, which is all the recordings and everything else. So I would just suggest, if you're not a member, go there and become a member. And plus, depending on how you do your taxes, like we kind of talked about, it would be tax deductible using it for your business. So that's just something I'll put in a quick plug for our group. And we are a nonprofit, been around since 1977. And we're here, as you know, just to help you. We're not trying to sell you something every week, but we do have stuff now and then that's worth your while, and we'll let you know about that. So,
yeah, thank you for mentioning that, John. Yeah, so if you're sitting on the fence, say, think about joining. You're not a member now. Big advantage here to do it before the end of the year, because we've decided at our board meeting that we're gonna have to raise rates a little bit. And we're still we're gonna be the least expensive group in town. That's why because we're a nonprofit, we're not trying to make any money off anybody. So, okay, anybody got any other final words?
Yeah, Chris, go ahead.
Oh, yeah, okay, I see him.
Yeah, just a question, as you're talking about meetings, the Monday lunch, is that still active?
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah, I just mentioned it first. I don't know if you came on after that.
I came out a little late. Sorry.
Yeah, it's the 5th of August at the Applebee's, the first Monday of every month. So we'll be there. I'll be there. Grace will be there, another board member, and usually a pretty good group of other people, and always have some good discussions. I think it sounds like Aaliyah's going to be there. She's been there the last several that I've been to. So, yeah, hope to see you there. Okay. Anybody else? Got anything? Yeah, Aaliyah says it's a good time. So yeah, if nothing else, you have a good time with a bunch of like-minded people. I mean, that's what I feel is the best thing about this organization. Because you don't always get all the good feedback from people when you tell them you're a landlord or you're a real estate investors. And so it's nice to get together with a bunch of other real estate investors and say, hey, I'm not doing something so bad after all. So and you get a lot of good networking and feedback and a lot of good ideas for improving your investment investment business. So, okay, well, if nobody has anything else, I think we'll call it a day. I'm getting about time for my lunch. So thank you all for coming on today. Hope to see you. If next Friday, or if not then, at the launch show a week from next Monday. And then at our Tuesday meeting. Thank you.
Goodbye, everybody.
Have a good one.
Goodbye.
Thank you. Bye, everybody.